Hello, yes, it's really me. Hello.
It is so great to meet you.
It's an absolute honor and a pleasure.
The pleasure's all mine.
I saw you on the phone. Yes. Are you pulling up?
Damn.
No.
Shit.
No.
Fuck.
No, no.
Did I miss?
No, absolutely. No, absolutely. The paparazzi have been after me for months now after the whole...
Yeah, I'm sorry.
No, it's not you. It's I just wanted to ask you, who are you talking to?
Nobody.
But you were talking.
No, I wasn't.
I saw your mouth moving.
I was checking.
I thought my agent told you that we only, not to tell anybody.
And I didn't.
We only wanted to see you and only you.
I was checking my messages. I was talking to my sister, Lillian. You know, she won't be a problem. I thought you were going to be here like 30 minutes ago, so she called, and I just, you know.
As long as she knows.
Absolutely. Yeah, it's fine. Totally fine.
It's fine?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
I really want to take in the moment, you know, I want to be in the zone, your zone, be in the space, be in the real space with you, and it's not often I can do that without, you know, I have like less than an hour to sort of soak up the environs.
I completely.
And that's more than most. I'm just saying it's a big deal that I'm here doing this with you.
I'm truly, truly sorry. All right.
Did you say I had a lot to learn? Well, baby, don't think I'm trying not to. Since this is the perfect spot to learn. Go on, teach me tonight.
Gonna be a great movie. I really mean that. I'm not just saying that because I'm writing, producing, directing, and also singing the title song. I really think it's gonna be a contender for the big one. Best picture. I mean, the scene of your intervention here in this park. Awards. Buckets of awards. Up half a dozen golden men in my arms.
I was on a conference call when you pulled up. I was on a conference call.
So everyone knows I'm here.
Yeah, everyone.
Yeah, could you have security park the decoy at the western gate and don't let anyone in? Yes, no one.
I didn't know you could do that.
Do what?
Shut down a park? Public park?
Do you know who I am?
Yeah, I think so.
Then yes, I can shut down a public park.
Wow. Yeah, I didn't know.
Can I have your phone? Just for the length of my stay.
I'll turn it off. I'll turn it completely
off. I'm
gonna
need your phone. to be absolutely honest with me. Don't let me get away with anything from my old bag of tricks.
I mean, I didn't know you had an old bag of tricks, but okay.
If I'm going to be inhabit this world of yours, I'm going to need you to keep me in it.
Yeah, okay.
I want real people, real folk, real talk. Yeah. You know what I mean?
Yeah, real talk.
Yeah. Yeah, I don't want a bunch of glamour pusses. I might just cast it with nobodies.
Nobodies?
Nobodies. Unheard ofs.
Okay.
You know, just go out into the community, you know, out into the street, better yet, into Popeye's Chicken and Biscuits, grab me some real folk.
I see.
We don't need a bunch of airbrush faces pretending.
But I was wondering about the thing you said about Popeye's.
And I want your family on set with us every day.
My family?
Every day, making sure we maintain the truth.
Yeah, I mean, they would love that. I was wondering...
Where were you tied?
What?
Where were you tied up?
I mean, it was over a year ago, so I don't really remember.
Show me.
Go on, teach me tonight.
I don't believe it.
Believe what?
I don't believe it happened that way.
Well, it did.
It's just not believable.
Sorry if my life isn't believable for you.
I believe you. I just don't believe it.
Wait, you just said...
And I don't think anyone else will.
What?
I just...
If we're talking about believability, first off, you're black.
You do know who you're talking to, right?
Yeah, you.
Yes.
Yeah, you're black.
Me?
You're black.
I'm not black.
You're not black?
Mm-mm. I'm a movie star. And a singer.
Yeah, you're a black movie star singer.
No, I'm a movie star. Singer.
Yeah, and you are black.
No, I don't think you understand. When you reach the level of fame that I have, race sort of falls away.
Falls away.
Falls away, like over a cliff. Like, when you reach the level of fame that I have, race sort of takes a running nosedive off of a cliff, and you're just left with movie star singer.
Okay.
And so if we could leave race out of the conversation, like way out of the conversation, like way back in Africa out of the conversation, that would be great.
Okay.
And I think you should apologize.
For what?
Well, you know for what.
Look, I'm sorry if me bringing up the fact that I'm white and you're black disturbs you, but I'm not going to apologize for stating the
fact. $1 million. $1 million is what the studio is thinking about paying you for the rights to your life. So I think you will indeed apologize to the movie star singer that you just insulted by calling her black.
I'm sorry for calling you black.
Apology accepted.
Thank you.
I'm sure we have a lot of questions for each other, and our schedule is extremely tight.
Yeah. Mm. To begin.
When was the last time you smoked crack?
I never smoked crack. I smoked meth.
Oh, we have to change it to crack for the movie.
But that's not accurate.
Black people don't smoke meth.
Oh, I'm pretty sure I know a few.
Black people in movies don't smoke meth. Black people in movies smoke weed and crack.
When was the last time you smoked crack?
As I write in my memoirs, there have been a few relapses over the years, but for the most part, I don't happen to smoke crack anymore.
For the most part?
For the most part, yeah.
Why is that?
Because crack is highly addictive.
And?
And I sell my shit and run around naked when I'm on it.
That hasn't stopped you before.
Yeah, I know.
So? What's stopping you now?
Well, as I write in my memoirs...
Fuck your memoirs. I have to embody the truth of the character, not what you've written in some book.
It's not some book, it's my life story.
I'm more interested in what's not in your life story.
But you're buying the rights to my memoirs.
I don't buy rights, darling.
Then who does?
The studio is considering buying your life rights. Considering. And they brought me here in order for you to convince me to do this movie, star in this movie as you, a crackhead alcoholic hoe.
But I thought my literary agent, she said you were practically signed, sealed, and delivered.
What am I, a letter?
My literary agent told me that.
She lied.
But that...
She lied. We all lie. We're in the business of lying.
I actually never was a whore.
Who said you were a whore?
You did. You said I was a crackhead alcoholic whore.
No, I didn't. I said you were a hoe.
Okay. Well, I never was a whore or a
alcoholic hoe. Oh, okay. So you expect me to believe that you're a crackhead and you're an alcoholic and you're not a hoe? Come on now.
Well, I'm
That'll
sorry.
That'll make no sense.
I'm sorry. I don't know. I just wasn't.
You smell like drink, you know.
What?
You smell like you got up this morning, had yourself a nice little drink to rub out the edges, and then you gargled with something awful and peppermint flavored. Am I right?
Wait a minute.
Look, yeah. I'm going to do this stupid little movie about your stupid little life. And you know why I'm going to do this stupid movie about your stupid little life? Because I want some Oscars, just like anybody else. Everybody just thinks folks just think I'm a movie star who's a singer who became a movie star. But I'm not just some singer who became a movie star. Them dummies at the studio keep after me about when are you going to record the soundtrack? When's the soundtrack coming out? We don't even have a damn script. And they're asking me when the soundtrack's coming out. I'm not just some singer who became a movie star. You know how many units I sold off of my last album?
No.
10 million. 10 goddamn million records sold. And that's the only reason they're even considering letting me on this film. I'm not just some singer who became a movie star. But that's all right, though. I still got me a few tricks up my sleeve. I'm gonna win me a bald-headed, butt-naked, golden motherfucker. You feel me? You one of them fake hoes?
Excuse me?
You one of them alcoholic, crackhead, bitch-ass hoes?
You know what? I've sat here while you ramble on and on about whatever crazy shit you've been rambling on about. Saying that my life ain't believable. You're not black, and I'm a crackhead alcoholic hoe. Well, guess what, Mrs. Movie Star Singer? You come in here like a fucking fairy tale on your fucking company jet, and you want some real talk? Yeah, here's some real talk. Fuck you, bitch.
Wait, that's her. That's her. That's zippity boom. That's who I wanted to talk to. Now we can get down to some nitty gritty. I want you to talk to me like that. Like you talked before rehab.
Let's see some zippity boom, boom.
Something wrong?
You don't really want to make a movie about my memoirs, do you?
Of course not. Anybody got time for that?
You just want the outrageous part.
I want the real parts. The human parts. I want this to be a real human story with real human heart. So I guess you've heard about my little incident.
Yeah, the one where you flipped your car.
Yes, that one.
Yeah, I heard.
I just left rehab.
Like rehab, or just...
Rehab. So while I'm sitting there in rehab, studio sending me all these scripts, and I'm reading through this load of crap and that load of crap. And then the studio sent me the galleys to your memoir. And I was like, wow, this is a story about rehab, and here I am sitting in rehab. It was just so... The people I used to know, before the fame, before the money. The studio sent me the galleys to your memoir, and they wanted me to sing the title song. I said, wrote them back, I want to write it myself. You know, I'd write it, produce it, direct it, star in it, and then I'd sing the damn title song. That's what selling 10 million off of record can get you. Opportunity. Even if it don't come with no damn bit of respect. You holding anything?
What?
You holding anything? A little bump, maybe?
No, I'm clean. I'm clean. I don't do crack.
I don't do crack either.
Good.
I make too much money to do crack.
I've heard that before.
Heard what before?
I make too much money to do crack.
Yeah, you heard it. I just said it.
No, I heard it before. I heard it before you said it.
I should go get that checked out. Look, I think we got off to the wrong start. Let's just pretend like I just got here.
Are you a lesbian? I thought I read somewhere.
You read something wrong somewhere.
Are you?
I have a husband and a child.
It's all lies. My memoirs, it's all lies. From start to finish. You know, it's right. It's not believable. I made it all up. In rehab. In rehab, everybody was telling me to read this one book. Sold the most copies in the world. So I read it. It moved me. The strength I felt from this one just tiny little book, this memoir. And so this woman, she came into rehab and she was at the bottoms, like the rock bottoms. So I went to my room to get this memoir for her. Because, you know, someone had given it to me when I was at my rock bottoms. I went to my room, got it, gave it to her. You know what she did? She slapped it to the ground. She said, "That's some bullshit, and you heard, that's some old bullshit." Sure enough, I pick it up, look in the front cover where nobody looks at it, said, "This book is a combination of certain facts and embellishments. Names, dates, places have been changed for literary effect. The reader should not interpret this book anything more than a work of literature." Remember it like it was yesterday. Yeah, you think I'd be angry? You think I want to find this man who changed my state of being? I want to find him and spin his face, but, you know, instead I thought, well, hell, I can lie. I know how to invent shit, alter the truth. I'm a goddamn expert at changing the truth. I've been doing it my whole damn life. So, I started writing my memoir.
It's a lie.
My life, my family, all lies.
All of it. It's all.
Are you a lesbian?
No.
No.
But I love her.
What's your name?
Robin.
Yeah, I think I read about her somewhere.
I had to give her up.
She's your one true thing.
Why do you say that?
You flipped your car. That's real.
For a moment, I thought I was famous enough. Thought I was famous enough, but I wasn't. I'm not. So I flipped my car. I thought that would end it, but they found me. Brought me back. Always finding me. Bringing me back.
Tell Robin you love her.
Did you tell your family you made up a bunch of lies about them?
Yeah.
No.
Is it helping?
What? Rehab?
Yeah.
You know, when you first arrive, they tell you you have a 90% chance of returning. And that's not very nice. It's not very nice at all. You know, they told me that when I started singing, too. They had a 90% chance of failure. That wasn't nice either. But rehab keeps me away from certain things, certain parts of myself, certain people I can't trust anymore.
No, everybody thinks it was him that started you on that stuff.
Everybody thinks a lot of stuff that ain't true. Church ain't so fresh and clean, my darling.
I mean, I'm not too big on religion neither, so you go right ahead.
I'm not talking about religion. I'm talking about the church. Church ain't got nothing to do with my religion. My relationship to God ain't got nothing to do with the church.
You ever regret any of it?
Who are you, Diane Sawyer?
I'm just asking.
No, I don't regret.
I just wonder if people who have everything...
I don't have everything. I don't have to tell Robin nothing. She knows.
You're addicted to her.
I don't like to think about myself as an addict. I think I have a bad habit. Like you. You're a liar.
That I am.
Well, this is going to make a perfect partnership. I'd like to see Zippity Boom now.
What?
I'd like to talk to Zippity Boom. Now.
What is that?
Motivation.
She keeps a Moët Chandon in a pretty cabinet with the meat cake, she says, just like Marie Antoinette. A building, a remedy for Khrushchev and Kennedy. At any time, an invitation you can't decline. Caviar and cigarettes, well-versed in etiquette. Extraordinarily nice. She's a killer queen, gunpowder gelatine, dynamite with a laser beam, guaranteed to blow your mind. Recommended at the price, insatiable in appetite. Wanna try? She never kept the same address. In conversation, she spoke just like a baroness. Middleman from China went down to gauge your mind. Then again, incidentally, in that way, perfume came naturally from Paris. Because she couldn't care less, fastidious and precise. She's a killer queen, gunpowder gelatine, dynamite with a laser beam, guaranteed to blow.